Good morning, our Gene to Gene family. I hope that you guys are doing well with us. We are happy. We are excited. We hope that you're excited with us to give God glory and to give God praise. Just right there where you're standing, I don't know who's standing next to you, who's sitting down, and just put your hands above your head and give God your best praise because He's worthy to be praised and to be adored. Are you ready? Come on, look at somebody in your house, in your room, in your dining room. Just ask them if you're ready, because we're going to give God some praise right now. Are you ready for us? Yes, come on, let's give God praise. Clap your hand. Woo! Hallelujah! en prijs vanmorgen. Some noise for Jesus. Jesus, hallelujah. He's the beginning, he's the end. He's the Alpha, he's the Omega. And we're going to fight our battles this morning through praise. And we're going to fight our battles through worship. How many of you agree with us this morning? Come on, band, make some noise. Come on, let's give God glory. Let's give God praise. Sing with us tonight, say, this is how I fight my battles. Come on, I want you to fight your battles through your praise this morning. This is how I fight my battles. Oh yeah, come on, sing, this is how. This is how I fight my battle. Oh, come on, sing it one more time. This is, and this is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Hey, this is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight, and this is how I find my battles. This is how I find my. Come on, raise your hands. Singing this song this morning is we're gonna tramp on every sickness, every disease this morning. So right there where you're standing and you're feeling sick in your body, I want you to lift your feet, raise your hands. Sickness, diseases, go in the name of Jesus. Cancer, AIDS, whatever it is, corona, whatever it is, we're gonna fight our battle and we lift up the name of Jesus by singing the song. Sing, this is how I fight my battles. 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 This is how I fight. Say, it may look like I'm surrounded. Oh God, we bless your name this morning. It may look like I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded. We are covered by your blood, oh God. There is nobody like you. You are the first. You are the last. You are the beginning and you are the end. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. And you have the last say today. And this is why we thank you. We came to honor you this morning, to give you praise and to give you glory. It may look like I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded. It may look like I'm surrounded by you. Hey, yeah. It may look like I'm surrounded by you. Yeah. Come on, let's lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, make some noise, band. Let's make some noise. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Yes, I adore you, Jesus. You're the lover of my soul.
Thank you, Jesus. Let's bow down and worship the Lord.
Standing, just open up your mouth right now. Just worship the Lord for a couple of seconds, if you don't mind. Right there, right there. I don't mind waiting on you, God. I said, I don't mind waiting on you, oh God. And Father, this morning, I'm standing with my hands open. And this is a token of surrender. I give my all to you, oh God. It is all for you this morning, Jesus. Your name, Jesus. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. Thank you this morning, God, for who you are and for what you are going to do. We thank you, Father. I think while the band is just playing, I was just thinking about this. I was thinking about what everyone is going through right now with this disease and things and sicknesses, and I want to encourage somebody this morning that's watching with us. I want to tell you that you're still going to cry out to God. He cannot answer you if you don't open up your mouth and tell him that you need him. But I want to encourage you to say, that he's here for you this morning. If the blind man kept his mouth, Jesus would not have heard him cry out. But by him opening his mouth and shouting out Jesus, the blind man could see today. Can we just stand this morning? Lift up your hands. Just lift up your hands. Everybody, just lift up your hands.
Dankie dat ons die vanmorgen kan aanbid, Koning Jesus. Ons aanbid U as die enigste, die levende, die opgestane Jesus, die almachtige Jesus, die skepper van die hemel en die aarde. Jesus, the one who created everything by merely speaking a word, that's Jesus, that is our God. We worship You, Lord, and we love You. We appreciate You. Heer, ons wil vanmorgen met ons stemme, maar ook met ons levens, met ons geloof, met ons gehoorzaamheid, met alles wil ons die naam aanbid. En Vader, dank U vir die woord. En ek bid opnuut vanmorgen dat die woord sal wees, een lig op ons pad en een lamp vir ons voet. Bid opnieuw vanmorgen, Here, dat die woord zal doen wat net die woord kan doen. Lord, thank you that we can pray for everyone that is in distress. Everyone, Lord, whose thoughts may be running in all kinds of directions at this very moment. En Here, ons wil elke gedachte gevangen neem tot gehoorzaamheid aan God. Ons wil nou Godse vrede uitspreek oor elke huis. Ons wil nou bid, Here, dat die elke geest van vrees sal uitjaag uit huise, uit lewens en uit omstandighede. Ons beveel jou vrees om die huise te verlaat in die naam van Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for your peace. Peace that surpasses all understanding. We bless you. We honor you. You are Jesus and there is no one like you. Amen. Ons loof die Here. Wat een voorreg was het om vanmorgen so die koning van die konings te aanbid. En ons wil, van my kant af wil ek ook sê, welkom, dankie dat u vanmorgen deel is van ons diens hier by Gen to Gen in Kuilsrivier. En mag die Here vir u seën en goed wees. Invite your family. And maybe afterwards, if this word spoke to you, you can share it with a friend or family member, maybe with a colleague. En mag die Here se woord so verkondig word reg oor die wereld. Nou, ons is vanmorgen aan die begin van ons 14 dae van vas en gebed, en ek wil volgende met die gesels oor vas en gebed, en my gebed is dat die Here deur sy Heilige Gees vanmorgen opnieuw hierdie in die gaan wakker maak, en die gaan lewendig maak, but my prayer is that God will stir something in your spirit, that you will participate, en of jy nou deel is van die gemeente al dan nie, as jy dalk luister net vir die eerste keer, that you will also be part of this, of these 14 days, waar ek glo die Here met ons wil kom ontmoet, met ons wil kom praat, en wil kom ingryp in ons levens en in ons omstandighede. Ek gaan net 4 verse lees, uit Matteus 4, Matteus 4 vanaf vers 1 tot 4, nou die opskrif is die versoeking van Jesus. Ons ken het goed, dit is een welbekende gedeelte. En het lees so, toe is Jesus deur die gees weggelei in die woestijn, om versoek te word deur die duivel. En nadat hy 40 dae en 40 nagte gevas het, het hy naderhand honger geword. En die versoeker het na hom gekom en gesê, as jy die seun van God is, sê dat hierdie klippe brode word. Maar hy antwoord en sê, daar is geskrywe, die mens sal nie van brood alleen lewe nie, maar van elke woord wat deur die mond van God uitgaan. Vers 2 sê, en nadat hy 40 dae en 40 nagte gevas het, het hy naderhand honger geword. The Bible is filled with examples of how we should and should not live. Wat die Here goedkeur en dit wat die Here afkeur. And some of the correct characters show us what and how things should be done, en ander wys vir ons wat en hoe dinge nie gedoen moet word nie. En dan sien ons as ons die woord van die Here lees dat daar is sekere karakters wat sekere eienskappe baie sterk na vore bring. En ek dink, as ons sekere name noem, dan associeer ons dit met hierdie eienskappe. If I mention the name Abraham,
we associate this name with faith.
Abraham is die vader van geloof. As ons praat van Salomo, dan praat ons van wysheid. When I mention the name Stephen, he showed commitment on the next level. En so kan ons aangaan en sien ons dat Godse woord,
al manne en vroue wat demonstreer en sê dat seker goed baie sterk
demonstreer vir ons. Maar die voorbeeld van al die voorbeelde, wanneer ons hierdie woord van die Here lees, bly Jesus Christus die Seun van God. And as Christians, he should always be our prime example of how we should live, what we should strive for, en die goed waarvan ons moet wegbly. En waar ons dan hierdie tydperk van vas en gebed begin vandag en binnegaan, it is important to note why we do what we do. En ek wil nou weer teruggaan en sê, as kinders van God is Jesus ons grootste voorbeeld. En wanneer ons dan vas en bid, is ons bezig om die voorbeeld van Jesus te volgen. And this is the first thing that I trust that you will remember. Fasting and prayer is following the example of Jesus Christ. En as ons dan die rest van die Nieuwe Testament lees, dan sien ons, daar is een klomp ander voorbeelde
waar mense gevas en gebid het. In other words, where the New Testament church followed the
example of Jesus. En een van hulle vind ons in Handelinge 13 vers 3. En ek lees so, hy sê, and when they had fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them, they sent them away. Nou as jy Handelinge 13 gaan lees, dan sien ons, dis een groep mense wat gevas en gebid het, and the Lord spoke to them, and the Lord said that they need to send away Paul and Barnabas. So, die Nieuwe Testamentiese kerk het hier die voorbeeld van Jesus van vas en gebed gevolg. When we read the New Testament, we will find more than 20 verses, more than 20 examples, where people fasted and prayed. So, when we call a time of fasting and prayer, we are not doing something strange. Ek wil vir jy sê, as ons een tydperk van vas en gebed roep, dan is het ook nie iets speciaals wat ons doen nie. Ons doen nie iets wat die AGS uitgedink het nie. We are not doing something of that gen to gen thought about. It's not some human thought. Weet jy wat?
As ons een tydperk van vas en gebed uitroep, dan is ons nie bezig om iets speciaals te doen.
It is not only for the super spiritual or the super holy. Vas en gebed was een deel van die kerk, soos wat bid by homself is, soos wat lofprysing is, soos wat aanbidding is, soos wat getuig is, so was vas deel van die lewe, van die elke dagse bestaan van die Nieuwe Testamentiese kerk. Fasting and prayer should be part of our normal relationship with Jesus. So as jy dalk vanmôre luister en toe ons begin te dink, vas is nie eintlik my ding nie.
Dis vir ander mense, I want to put it like this, that God
gave us the example. The New Testament church followed the example and we need to do it as well. Elke kind van God behoort vast deel van sy lewe te maak. So, hierdie moet ons vastmaak. Hoekom vast ons? Jesus, ons verlosser en saligmaker, the prime example, the one that we are following, he fasted and prayed and if he thought it necessary to fast and pray, we should do the same. Want soms het ons hierdie gedachte dat het is optioneel.
It is not optional. It should be part of your daily walk with the Lord. En as ons dan verder gaan kyk,
so hoekom en wanneer het mense gevas in die Nieuwe Testament, dan sien ons een klomp voorbeelde van hoekom en wanneer. Ons sien ook dit, they did not fast and pray to just be part of the crowd. They did not fast and pray to be funny. They did not fast and pray and saw themselves as something special or something different. Hulle definitief ook nie gevas en gebid om gewig te verloor nie. Ons vind het nêrens in die woord van die Here nie. Nou, daar is baie redes hoekom hulle het gedoen. Ek wil net drie vir die noem vanmôre. En die laaste ene is dit wat die Here in my hart regtig gelê het. In hierdie tyd van vas en gebed by Gen to Gen gemeente. En die eerste een is dit, hulle het gevas
en gebid voor belangrike gebeure. And when we look at the passage that we read from,
Jesus went through a time of fasting and prayer, 40 days of fasting and prayer, at the commencement of his earthly ministry. En ek dink jy gaan met my saamstem, as daar ooit iets groots en belangrik was, wat plaasgevind het, was dit die aardse bediening van Jesus Christus. And it was introduced by a time where Jesus, the Son of God, find it necessary to fast and to pray. And as ek en jy kind van God is, we surely need to follow his example. As ons kyk na hierdie selfde voorbeeld, dan sien ons hierdie tydperk van vas en gebed is gevolg deur aanvalle van die vijand. He had to prepare himself for all the attacks of the enemy. And a time of fasting and prayer is a time of strengthening our spiritual lives. Het is belangrijk dat ons het deel sal maak van ons geestelike discipline. As ons gaan kyk na dit wat ons net gelees het in Handelinge, dan sien ons hierdie dat hulle het gevas en gebid voordat hulle belangrike besluite moes neem. In a time of uncertainty. En nou wil ek het persoonlik maak, and I want to ask you this question. Are you currently sure about everything in your life? Are you sure about tomorrow? Are you sure how to handle relationships? Are you sure
how to act in your job? Are you sure about your job? Weet jy hoe om met die besigheid te werk?
In hierdie regulasies en met hierdie situasie waarin ons is, is jy seker daarvan? Weet jy precies, is daar by jy geen twyfel en niks nie? En as die antwoord is, ja, ek is 100% seker, then I want to tell you that you don't need to fast and pray, then you actually don't even need the Lord. Maar as daar by jou enige twyfel is, oor wat en hoe en wanneer en hoe sal ons maak. I want to encourage you, I want to urge you to spend some time in fasting and prayer. Do you need wisdom? Do you need guidance? Het jy Godse voorsiening nodig? Het jy Godse beskerming nodig? Wonder jy hoe om te maak? Why don't you join us in this time of fasting and prayer? Ek wil vanoggend vir u sê, in Jesus naam, u het niks om te verloor nie. U het niks om te verloor nie. And if you've never done it before, this is the best time to do it. En is ook vanoggend die beste geleentheid om hierdie besluit te maak, dat ek gaan vas in gebed deel maak, gereelde deel maak van my wandel met Jesus Christus. So, Jesus het vir ons die voorbeeld gestel. Die Nuwe Testamentiese kerk het onder andere voor hulle belangrike besluite geneem het gevas en gebid. Jesus het gevas
en gebid met die aanvang van sy bediening voordat die vijand op aangeval.
Die tweede ding wat ek vir u wil noem. Nuwe Testamentiese kerk het gevas en gebid to see miracles happen that would not normally happen. En jy kan daarvan gaan lees in Markus 9. En die story loop so dat Jesus is besig met 'n groep mense en 'n ander groep mense kry sy disippels en hulle bring 'n duiwelbesetene na sy disippels toe en hulle vra vir sy disippels om vir hierdie persoon te bid and they were unable to cast out the demon. And when Jesus came, they asked Jesus, Jesus, please pray your disciples were not able to cast out the demon. En Jesus antwoord hulle so. Hy sê, hierdie geslag sal nie uitgedryf
sonder vas en gebed.
Ons staan voor 'n onskynbaar voor 'n onskynlike onstuitbare virus. These disciples faced a demon. They were unable to cast out the demon. Jesus said, "You need to spend time in fasting and prayer, and if you do that, you will be able to cast out this demon." En ons staan voor hierdie vyand. Hier in ons land, reg oor die wêreld. And it seems as if there's no stopping this virus. It seems as if this virus is just causing havoc all over the world. Dit lyk asof hy sommer net maak soos wat hy wil en ons weet nie hoe sal ons hom ooit kan stop nie. Wil volgende vir vra, dink jy dat hierdie virus kom van die Here af? Never. All the good and perfect gifts come from the Father of lights. Hierdie virus kom van die vijand homself. Dis hy. Fasting and prayer can unlock powers that otherwise is not operating or available. In kerk van die Here Jesus Christus, we are at a time where we seriously, urgently need the Lord.
And we are praying, and we have been praying for quite some time. And I think it's time to start fasting and praying and trusting the Lord.
Sy het Markus 9 gesê, julle moet vas en bid, en dan sal julle in staat wees om ook hierdie duivel uit te drijf. I believe that if the children of God will humble themselves, will fast and pray and seek his face, God will heal his land. And God can stop, and God will stop this virus in Jesus' name. So if you are concerned about the virus, as jy bekommerd is oor die impak en die gevolge van hierdie virus, as jy dalk situasies in die gesig staar, en jy weet nie hoe sal jy maak nie, dit voel dit oorweldig jou, dis te groot, dis te ingewikkeld, dis te sterk. Why don't you seek God?
In a time of fasting and prayer,
in a time of fasting and prayer. En ek dink, meeste van ons het gesien dat niemand is gevrywaar nie. Niemand kan sê, dit sal nie met my gebeur nie, dit sal nie met my gesin gebeur nie. But I believe if we trust the Lord, he will intervene for us. He will come through for us. He will do what seems impossible to do. Denk as daar ooit 'n inenting is, wat ons nodig het, is dit 'n inenting van God se Heilige Gees, van sy Heilige Gees krag. And when we spend time in fasting and prayer, you will experience the power of God's Holy Spirit in your life like you don't experience usually. Dan die laaste, nommer 3. Hoekom, waarom het die Nuwe Testamentiese kerk gevas? En ons vind het ook in die Ou Testament. Hulle het gevas en gebid, wanneer hulle self herde laat.
Aan die Here. When was there was a rededication to the Lord.
En Joel lees ons iets mooi. Sy sê, yet, even now, declares the Lord. En ek wil het vanmorgen vir u sê, Gen to Gen gemeente, ek wil het vanmorgen vir u sê wat luister, wat nie deel is van ons gemeente nie. Yet even now declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping and with mourning. With fasting, with weeping and with mourning. O kerk van die Here Jesus Christus, we need the Lord, we need him like never before. Ons het nodig dat ons opnuut onszelf aan hom sal oorgee en om onszelf aan hom sal wy.
I'm talking about a true, real commitment, a surrender to the
Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Is in verhouding met Jesus het te goedkoop geraak. Many people call themselves Christians, but they twist God's word. Hulle besluit, ons sal hierdie vat en ons hou van die, maar ons hou nie van daar nie. Many Christians have become lukewarm.
Because we think we can twist and manipulate the word of God. Ons dink, ons
kan maar die Here dien en om die Here te dien is net om liedjies te sing en ons hande op te sit, op te steek en te sê amen en halleluja. To serve the Lord means that from time to time we will dedicate, we will consecrate ourselves to the Lord. Hy sê in Joel 1 vers 14, die ESV vertaling sê, consecrate a fast.
Call a solemn assembly. Gather the elders and
all the inhabitants of the land to the house of the Lord your God and cry out to the Lord. And this is my cry, this is my prayer, this is my hope, this is my desire, dat in die volgende 14 dae, dat ons in die besonder en korporatief as
die kerk, een tydperk van vas en gebed sal deurgaan en die naam van die Here sal
aanroep soos nog nooit van tevore nie. We need the Lord, we need the Lord, we need the Lord. And yes, when we fast and pray, we put in some extra effort to seek the face of God. Ons doen ander goed. Ons doen ook goed anders. Even when we spend time in with Daniel fast, ek eet nog, maar ek eet ander goed. Ek eet op ander maniere. En wanneer ek vol vast, I only take in fluids. I don't eat any food. En as ek bevoorreg is om nie baie fisiese werk te vat nie, dan drink ek net water. And I spend time
in prayer, fasting and prayer, seeking the face of the Lord. Ons gebruik die tyd en ons maak moeite om met Jesus tyd te spandeer.
Die tyd en energie wat ons normaalweg spandeer in die koop, voorberei en die eet van kos, spandeer ek nou met hom. En u sal verbaas wees. Ek wil dit vanaand onomwonde stel. U gaan verbaas wees hoeveel tyd ons spandeer aan die koop, die voorberei en die eet van kos. We spend a lot of time on that. Ons moet tyd
inruim om te vas en te bid. And fasting without
prayer is not biblical fasting. Ek moet dit oor en oor sê, want ek sien baie keer dat mense vas, but there's nothing different to their prayer life. They don't even pray at all, or they don't pray more than normally. Fasting and prayer goes hand in hand. Fasting and prayer goes hand in hand.
Die Griekse woord vir vas is beteken to abstain from food.
En op 'n stadium het ek gewonder so hoekom het ons nie eet nie? Hoekom is vas om nie te eet nie? You see, what I've realized is that, and anyone who have fasted before will tell you that food plays
a major role in our lives. And unless you fasted, you will know it. You won't know it.
Nooit gevast het nie, sal jy dit nie weet nie. As jy gevast het, dan weet jy dit. We think about it. We even use food for purposes more than maintaining our bodies. We use food to comfort ourselves. Ek hou van die Afrikaanse woord trooskos. Ons eet om beter te voel. There's one comforter. His name is Jesus. And the moment I decide to set aside food and ask him to be my comforter, to spend time, quality time with him, I will find that he is more
of a comforter than any food can ever be. Die beste trooskos
kan nie glad nie eers opweeg met die trooster Jesus Christus nie. Fasting and prayer is a way of focusing on God in a special and in a powerful way. En vanoggend gaan ek vir u jok as ek sê, vas en bid is maklik. Dit gebeur sommer vanself. Dit is nie maklik nie. Val die eerste 2, 3, 4 dae, dit is moeilik, ons vlees rebelleer. But it is very special when it comes to our relationship with the Lord. Wanneer ek kom en sê, Here, my honger en my dors na u is groter as my honger en my dors na kos. You are the bread of life. Ek kan nie net van kos alleen leef nie, brood alleen, sê die woord, maar ek het nodig om u stem te hoor. I need to spend time in your presence.
Sien, wanneer ons vas en bid, bring dit ons by 'n plek van
al die ander goed wat belangrik, wat ons gedink het is belangrik, wat ons besef, dis nie regtig so belangrik nie. Die belangrike is Jesus Christus. En volgend wil ek vir jy net die praktiese riglyne wees prakties. If you've never fasted before, don't think you can
start immediately and you're not going to eat for the next 14 days, you will only have water.
Tensy jy baie tyd in die teenwoordigheid van die Here spandeer, you will not make it. And you will be discouraged and you will feel like a failure. Wees prakties. Begin met 'n dag of twee. Vas elke tweede dag of elke derde dag. Vas net 2 of 3 dae op 'n slag aanvanklik. And train your body and discipline your body. En 'n goeie manier om vol vas in te lei is om te Daniel vas. En as ek woorde gebruik wat jy nie van weet nie, you are welcome to contact the office. We will give you more information. If you have a medical condition, consult your doctor. Beplan jou gebedstye. En ek moet dit eintlik 10 maal sê, beplan jou gebedstyd. Beplan jou gebedstyd.
Beplan jou gebedstyd. Otherwise it will not happen. Wees ernstig in wat jy doen. Fasting and prayer is not something we do on the sideline. When we decide to fast and pray, it is the main thing. It should be the main thing. Wees ernstig. Don't just give up.
Moet nie super skuldig voel as jy ergens 'n fout maak en sê, oh, ek het dit nie gemaak nie, ek gaan my eerder ophou, I will never be able to master fasting, moet dit nie doen nie. Ons het 9 jaar in Upington geblei en daar het ons in februari 'n maand van vas en gebed gedoen. Februari in Upington is druiwe oes tyd. So as pastoor, en daai tyd het ons nog kinders in die huis gehad, het ons sultanas, en het ons hannepoot druiwe gaan kry. Sulke kratte vol. Nou die van die wat weet hoe dit proe, dis ongelooflik lekker.
So we have some of it in the fridge. For the children.
But more than once, I caught myself taking some of the grapes, and after the third or the fourth grape, I realized that, oh, I'm fasting, I should not be doing this. En aanvankelijk het die vijand my baie skuldig laat voel, tot Godse Heilige Geest my sê, luister man, stop man net en gaan aan, continue.
Fasting is not the end of the world. Just continue, be vigilant. Here, ek het u nodig, kom ontmoet my. Ek kan nie sonder u. Fasting and prayer
is not to impress people. It is not to impress people. Die Bybel sê eintlik, ander meneers weet wanneer ek vas en bid nie. Jesus het hom baie sterk uitgespreek, want hy sê, hier is 'n groep mense, en hulle tree so op dat almal moet weet wanneer hulle vas en bid, en hulle lyk toch so hartseer, hulle lyk toch so moedeloos. Listen, child of God. Fasting and prayer is not to impress people. Fasting and prayer is to seek the face of the Lord. Wil jy ander moet sê, jo, baie goed, shame, jy kry seker swaar, it's not about that. It's about seeking the face of the Lord. En daar gaan uitdagings wees. Een partij van die uitdagings is fisies, ander is geestelik, ander is emotioneel. As het vir my sleg was, dan sou het ons aangemoedig het. Nee, vas 'n bietjie, vas nog 'n bietjie, bid nog 'n bietjie. You will quickly realize that the moment you make the decision to fast and prayer,
the enemy will try to distract you, to stop you from fasting and prayer.
Ewe skielik, word jy na verjaarsdagpartytjies toe uitgenooi, waar jy nooit na toe uitgenooi was. Ewe skielik, nooi mense jou vir ete, wat jou nog nooit genooi het vir ete nie. En is hy ouwens wat jy gehoor het, as jy daar eet, eet jy somme baie lekker.
You may experience headaches, dizziness,
and even other attacks on your health. The enemy want to attack your relationship with the Lord, he wants to hamper it. And therefore, he wants you to stop fasting and praying. Hy gaan dalk goed by jou werk probeer, dalk goed in jou huwelik, dalk goed in jou besigheid. He wants to distract you. But the rewards of purposeful, well-spent time in fasting and prayer completely outweighs the effort it takes. En ek wil vir jy sê, gaan kyk maar in Godse woord, jy sal dit sien, oor en oor, weer en weer, vra enige persoon,
wat al gevas en gebid het, hulle sal het vanmorgen kan bevestig. En dit is so, somtyds, dan ervaar ons die voordeel van hierdie tyd van vas en gebed, onmiddellik, in our own spirit something happens.
We see changes in the atmosphere. We see changes in circumstances. We see changes in lives. We see changes in households. By die werk, ons sien hierdie goed gebeur. En is wonderlik. and it's encouraging. En ons voel, wel Here, dis die moeite werd om te vas. But then sometimes, seemingly, gebeur daar niks nie. Ek voel nie regtig iets in my gees nie. Ek sien niks gebeur in omstandighede nie. Dit lyk of dit net so onveranderd gaan. But I want to ensure you, that whenever we fast and pray, God is working.
We will never know what
He stopped from happening because of our time of fasting and prayer. Ons sal nooit gebeur wat deurbrake kom dalk 'n week of 'n maand of 'n jaar later, maar vanweer die tyd wat ek en jy gespandeer het in vas en gebed nie. Ek wil vanmôre ten slotte sê, gee jou geestelike lewe die begin wat hy verdien hier in die begin van 2020. A time spent in serious fasting and praying is like putting your spiritual life on steroids. And believe me if I tell you that we will need this during this coming year. We will need this as children of God to be the light and the salt that God has called us to be. Ons het dit nodig, want as ons na die kerk kyk, dan besef ons, die kerk is nie wat die Here wil hê ons moet wees nie. Therefore we need to humble ourselves. We need to seek His face. We need to pray. We need to
spend time in fasting and prayer so that God can change us.
And after He has changed us, kan Hy ons huise verander? Kan Hy ons omgewing, ons stad, ons land en ons kontinent verander? Starting 2021, in a time of fasting and prayer,
is a very good decision. Is die beste besluit, is die beste ding wat jy kan doen aan die begin van hierdie jaar. Nou wil ek vra, as die Here met jou praat,
of vas en gebed deel is van jou normale verhouding met die Here nog tot hiertoe, en of jy dit nog nooit gedoen het nie. If you need the Lord, and if you are willing to trust Him to help you, to spend some time in fasting and prayer, dit deel te maak van jou focus, in the next 14 days, maar ook om dan daarna dit deel te maak van jou verhouding met hom. You need to give him some indication dat, Here, hier is ek. Ek het gehoor, u praat met my. I want to commit myself. I need you. Lord, I hear the call of your word that we should fast and pray and seek your face. And I want to be part of those who are going to do that. Steek op jou hand. Staan op. Doe net iets. As indikasie dat jy God se stem gehoor het. En ons gaan nou bid, Here. It's an honor and it's a privilege to serve you.
And we can never earn or deserve any
of your greatness, any of your goodness, any of your blessings. Here, vas en gebed is ook nie 'n manier van verdien nie. Dis 'n manier van gee. Waar ek myself kom gee. My tyd kom gee. En my liggaam dissiplineer om die aangesig te soek. And Lord, if we ever needed you, we need you now. I need you. I need you like never before in my life. En ek besef elke dag,
ek het u vandag meer nodig as wat ek u gister gehad het. Ek weet ook ek gaan u môre meer nodig hê as vandag.
And Lord, I want to pray for everyone who by some way indicated to you, not to me, indicated to you that, Lord, I'm going to spend some time in fasting and prayer in these coming 2 weeks. And I'm going to make it a regular part of my relationship
with you.
And Lord, I'm excited about the next 2 weeks. The time that we will spend with you. En Here, vas is ook een uitroepe, Here, u moet meer word en ek minder. Wees u alles en ek niks. Mag dit gebeur in hierdie tyd, is my gebed in Jesus naam. Amen. En terwijl die mense na vore kom, wil ek u net herinner aan twee goed. So, ons maand van vas en gebed het vandag begin. En ons het deur die gemeente, we've shared some information about the prayer points. Ons het ook vir u gevra om aan te dui, watter dae is u bereid om te vas. En as u meer inligting nodig het, kontak ons, stuur vir ons 'n WhatsApp, kontak die kantoor, ons gaan meer met u gesels. Ons wil graag soveel as moontlik mense hê, ons wil al die dae vol maak, sodat ons hierdie 14 dae, elke dag, ten minste een persoon het wat gaan vas. And we ask you all to pray as we send through these prayer points to you. En dan die laaste ene, wil ek ook vir allemaal wat getrou bydra sê, baie dankie, mag die Here vir u seën, mag die Here vir u goed wees. En wat 'n voorreg is dit om te kan gee vir die werk van die Here, om te kan gee omdat hy 'n gewer is, om te kan gee because we can never outgive God. And when we talk about a tithe and offerings, it is not giving it, it is bringing it. Kan ek sê, ons gee dit nie, ons bring dit.
Want ons gee dit behoort in elk geval aan hom. En jy sien die bank besonderhede op die skerm. Jy kan dit EFT, jy kan hoor, dit kom ingee maandag tot vrijdag van 9:30 tot 12:00, kan jy dit ook inbring.
And if you can't move, you can phone us and we will even collect it somewhere. Mag die Here vir u seën, mag die Here vir u goed wees en deel asseblief met ons u deurbrake, deel met ons hoe die Here met u praat in hierdie tydperk van vas en gebed. Dankie dat u hierdie tyd saam met ons spandeer het. Sing saam met ons die laaste lied saam en mag die Here baie goed wees vir u. Shalom.